Hey there, everyone, and welcome back to another video in the Dice Tower's continuing coverage from Reno, Nevada of the GAMA Trade Show 2018. This time, I'm joined by Ian from Catan Studio.
Hello.
And hello, it's good to see you.
Likewise.
And I see here you've set up a version of Catan, but I'm intrigued because this is unlike anything I've seen, so I'm very interested to find out what's going to be introduced in this version.
Yeah, where's the hex board, right?
Mm-hmm. So
this is the newest, soon-to-be release from Catan Studio, and partnering with Cosmos and Catan GmbH, Catan Histories: Rise of the Inkas. Now, what our histories line tends to do, and we have a few titles in it, is it explores an era of human history through the game of Catan.
Okay.
So, in merchants of Europe, you're developing trade routes and trading throughout Europe. In Settlers of America, you're expanding your railroads out west. And in Rise of the Inca, we're exploring the rise and fall of civilizations that lead to a grander empire. In this case, the Empire of the Inca.
Okay.
So here we have an area of jungle and mountainous Peru in the Andean region of South America. And the gameplay for Rise of the Inca is fairly similar to Catan. You're still building settlements, roads, okay. Cities. They're all worth points. You roll your dice to collect your resources, trade. The same basic gameplay to do all of that. With the twist is where it works out.
Okay.
You're going to take your civilization, each player, through three different eras. And each era is signified by a victory point threshold.
Okay.
So the first era, for example, is when you hit 4 victory points. You will immediately remove all of your roads from the board. You will then take vines to signify that your tribe or civilization has gone to decline and is slowly being retaken by the jungle, and you will place them over your beautifully sculpted Incan architecture pieces that we'll be doing here.
Are those the actual sculpts that are going to be?
These are the actual sculpts, yes. This is a prototype. Uh-huh. We have the sculpts of the vines, we have the sculpts of the settlements, cities, and then here are the roads.
Nice.
And then here we have the robber piece with some Inca warriors and their llama. Or Yama, however you would like to pronounce it. When you hit your victory point threshold and you go into decline for your first or second era, your cities and settlements will be reclaimed by the jungle.
Okay.
You'll remove all your roads, and then you'll take another settlement and find a free space on the board, respecting the distance rule of Catan, which is the two road mm-hmm. segment lengths, basically, and then place there, and then you'll continue the game from that point.
Okay.
Now, your settlements and cities in decline will still get you resources during the production phase. However, now that they are in decline, they can be stolen by your opponents.
Ah.
So if I see that you are about to go into decline, or you have, I can build my roads out toward your area and build my own settlement in that place now. Now I have taken your sweet spot, and I get this wood or whatnot when that comes up. You can build over your own settlements too, so you can have a bit of a strategy there to protect your investment, I guess, lack of a better word. You'll do that twice, and when you hit your third victory fresh point, that's the victory condition.
Okay.
And then you will have ushered in the rise of the Incan Empire for this game. And that's the gist of this one. There are a few other rule variants. We have new commodities for this game, fish, cocoa, and feathers, and those can be traded for other resources. We have your standard Catan resources with wood, or in this case, we have potatoes and crops instead of wheat, bricks, and llama instead of sheep.
Of course.
Also, the longest road and largest army don't create straight victory points anymore. So as you're building your roads out, because as you go into decline, you remove them anyway.
That's right, yes.
So what the longest road does is it gives you a trade advantage, a one use, and the largest army allows you to mitigate the placement of the robber.
Okay.
In this for when you've claimed it, when you're playing your warrior cards.
Nice. And does each player get one of the little aids that tells them about their decline thresholds?
Yes. So everybody will have their own little player board as a kind of a reminder to go along with their building cost sheet. And this isn't the final art right now. So this is all pending final approval by by Klaus and the team. But yes, you'll have similar to a Game of Thrones Catan, you'll just place all of your buildings on this. So as you're going through, you'll take them off because there are rules for the amount of roads and settlements and cities per era that you can have.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, I really like that idea of the different eras, and you know, your one portion goes in decline, and you kind of branch out from there, and the other players or yourself can build on those ruins when they find them.
Yes,
it's really intriguing.
Yeah, it's a very interesting twist on the classic Catan.
Absolutely, cool. So, where in the production process is this then?
So we're looking for a release of quarter three, most likely early September, but we may get lucky and have some copies for Gen Con.
Oh, that would be great.
Yeah,
that'd be great to see. Cool. And when it does hit, whether it's Gen Con or later, what's the estimated MSRP for it?
So Rise of the Inkas is going to be $65 here in the States, and comes with, what is that? It's over 110 sculpted minis.
Nice.
I don't know if you can get a close-up of those. Those pieces, they did a really good job.
Yes.
of using the Incan like high-peaked sculptures. Well, it's not sculptures, roofs for their buildings. The robber pieces are great. Yeah, it's going to come in the classic Catan colors red, orange, blue. And in this case, it's a little bit more of a gray than a white. Just for the plastic pieces, it looks a little better that way. It's chocked with, full of these little plastic bits, all of your jungle pieces. And we're really looking forward to it. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Sounds great. So cool. Thank you so much for sharing that with me, Ian.
Yeah.
And
thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. And thanks for joining us, viewer, as well. And for more of the Dice Towers videos from the GAMA Trade Show, be sure to stay tuned to the channel, and we'll be posting a lot more of them real soon.